Hi, I'm Keith with Danfoss Food Retail Controls, and today's video will be on troubleshooting communication errors.
Thanks, Keith. Today we'll cover the five major things to check for if you're having communication issues with your Danfoss equipment. If you have a red error light at your communication module or case controller, or if you have offline alarms at your system manager, the first thing to try is to run a rescan. The rescan can be done either locally at your 800 controller or remotely using StoreView desktop. The next thing you want to check for is your supply power to your communication module or case controller. In the case of a communication module, your supply power is listed on the top of the module, and the same is true for the case controllers. So for a communication module, we need 24 volt AC or DC, which is shown here on the top of the communication module. If the rescan doesn't work and your power supply is correct, the next thing to check for is your end-of-line resistor. Your end-of-line resistor needs to be a 120 ohm resistor at the end of each loop. So this needs to be on either your 800 or your communication module or case controller. Whatever is at each end of the loop needs to be terminated. As you can see on your screen, if the 800 is in the middle of the loop, the terminating resistor would be off. If the 800 is at the end of the loop, your terminating resistor or your resistor switch would be on, and you would also have to have your terminating resistor or your resistor switch on at the other end of the loop. So it's important to note that the newer communication modules come with a terminating resistor switch, which would need to be in the off position for all nodes except the end of the loop. You could also have a small resistor like this that would be physically wired across the signal and ground of your communication loop at the nodes at the end of your loop. The next thing to check for is your shield wiring on your communication loop. As you can see on your screen, the shield needs to be wired across each node, and this needs to only be terminated at your 800 system manager. If you terminate this to an external ground somewhere else in the loop, you can create ground voltage, and that will not be good for your communication loop. The next thing to confirm is your wiring polarity. Modbus is polarity specific, so you need to honor the polarity, whereas LawnWorks is not polarity specific, but it's always best to honor the polarity. The last two major things to check for are the overall length of your wire, which should not exceed 4,000 feet per run without a repeater. And you also need to check for your communication cable type. So for TP78, for our older style equipment, this follows the level 4 cable specifications. And for the newer RS485 equipment, we follow the general EIA RS485 guideline. As you can see on the screen, here are some additional specifications that we require for the different wire types. Sometimes people ask if you can check with a DC voltmeter the communication reading to troubleshoot your communication loop. And you really would need a scope in order to check this. So you could use something like a picoscope, but you can't use a regular DC voltmeter to troubleshoot your communication loop. In addition, anytime you make any of these changes that we've talked about, you would want to run a rescan from your 800 system manager to see if you've cleared up your communication issues. And you can tell that when your communication alarm goes away for good, or if the red light goes away at the communication module. And this is how we troubleshoot the Danfoss communication loops.
For more information on this topic, see the description below. And for more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thank you for watching.